her senior year. She was the president of her senior class. She's been successful in everything that she's set her mind to, and I know that she's going to be successful in the days ahead. We love you, girl. We thank you for your life and for your example, for your patience, and that you'll always be part of this church and your family we love. And sometime if you have a chance, you should see some of the baskets that she, I guess they would say woven, that she has woven. And they are beautiful. Matter of fact, I think she can start her own business if she wanted to. But they're very beautiful. Many, many accomplishments. We want to thank you, Monica, to you and Tony, you know, the family that has had part of raising this beautiful young lady. And congratulations to you as well. And Shaylee, this is one of my favorite things to give as a gift. I know that you have your own, but I pray that as we give you this Bible from the church, this is from the church, that it will always hold you and keep you. You'll find that it's a rock, it's a guide, it's joy, it's happiness, it's a discipline. And the psalmist says, "Thy word, O Lord, is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." And no matter which direction the Lord would call you as your vocation, if you'll seek his word, he'll feed you, he'll show you, and he'll thank you, Myra. I love that song. And thank you for your giving.
Running faster.
Take a little want to discipline ourselves, getting into the Word, praying, fellowshipping and worshiping together, and then keeping our eyes on the Lord. Now, that was the introduction. We'll try to conclude with these thoughts. The conclusion. If we will join Jesus in this race, if we'll get into the race by faith, by trusting Jesus as our Savior, He's going to come into our lives and He's going to dwell there. He's going to bless us. He's going to help us sort things out in our life that are not good for us. And He will put things into our life that will glorify Him. It's really pretty simple. He does an exchange program. It changes our sins for blessings. He exchanges our chaos for His peace. He exchanges our darkness with His light. Amen. He exchanges our death with His life.
Amen.
I am the way, the truth, and the life, He says. The conclusion, though, is found if we run the race with Him. We find the words of Paul in 2 Timothy. I love these words. He says, he said, I know my departure or my leaving is at hand, knowing that it was close. But he goes on to say to young Timothy, I have fought a good fight. Wow. It is a fight. The spirit and the flesh will fight. The good and the wrong will fight sometimes. Light and darkness battle sometimes in our heart. But I've fought a good fight, he says. I have finished my course. And that in the NIV it says, I have finished my race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not to me only, but to all him also that love his appearing. Brothers and sisters, someday the race will be over.
Amen.
And if we ran for him, he will meet us at the gates of heaven. And he will reward us with a crown, our victor's wreath. I told a story years and years ago. I thought of it this morning when I was shaving. And I don't know if I can tell it exactly the way that I told it before. I can't remember the man's name, but the story goes something like this. There is a mini marathon in this well-known city. Many people had entered it. Many well-known runners had planned for it and entered it. And then, finally, the race started. And those that were really built for running, that ran many marathons or many marathons, they took off and they led the pack. And finally, the one that was suspected to win the race did win the race. Record time, it was. But in the race was one that no one else knew, but had always had a desire to run in one of the well-publicized races. He had some physical restrictions in his life. He walked with a limp, and when he ran with a greater limp. He had never ran in a marathon or mini marathon before. His pace was slower, more like a walk than a run. Matthew was so slow that they were already thinking that everybody had finished that were running. They were already beginning to take the barricades off the streets. And they would see as he attempted to run, to limp, to struggle. Determined to finish that race, regardless of how badly he was hurting, or regardless of how long it took him. And finally, there were times that people were booing him because it was taking him so long. But then as he went down the last stretch, the boos changed to cheers because people recognized the effort that he was putting forth to run that race. He continued to clumsily trot along, and finally he went, he passed that finish line. The people cheered and rejoiced with him. But there was one in the crowd. He had never met him before, didn't know anything about him. But he had watched him come down that last stretch of distance. And it was the one that had finished the race 3 hours earlier, received the victor's crown and the medal. And the one that had run the race, won the race, came to this one man that was far behind everyone else. To many, the race was over a long time ago. But he took his medal, lifted it from his own shoulders, and put it on the shoulders of that man that was crippled. Said to her, "You're the winner today because you've endured. You've stayed with it when it would have been easier to quit. Even when there were those who were booing, you continued to go forward. You're the winner." I visualize. See, Jesus has already run this race for us.
Amen.
He had to go through by the way of the cross. And he is now seated at the right hand of the Father. And he's watching you and I just now. He knows all of our struggles. He knows there are times that we feel more like quitting than going on. He knows when we hurt, when we're disappointed. He knows when we're criticized, sometimes booed, other times rejected. But we'll finish the race. One day, he'll put that victor's crown on us.
Amen.
A crown of righteousness. Others have said, "What is a crown of righteousness?" I think, Brother Paul, it's a crown of blood.
Amen.
That he's saying now, you will have life.
Amen.
Let's run the race.
Amen.
Never give up.
Amen.
Someone said it's always too early to quit. Never give up. Stay focused. If you watch him, he'll never ever leave you astray. And one day we'll gather around his throne. And we will rejoice forever, evermore.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Let's stand. You didn't think you'd get out this early, did you?